does it first. But when you schlep yourself, to go to somebody's chasna, and you can't even make it out the door, because you can't. And with your last whisper, you ask them to come out to wish a mazel tov. So what type of feelings does that build? When you say v'avta hakamecha, you're saying your metzias, those are words, nafshay. His neshama, he put out day in, day out, after long, hard days, not to miss simchas, because he felt, and there's a myriad of stories, I'm not going to say them over, of times when on a small chash of somebody's pia, he would go all out to do it. When that's your attitude, so when you say v'avta hakamecha, you're spitting out your nefesh, they're not words. One more inyan. There's a perek in Tanakh, extraordinary perek. It's very far, so I guess people don't get to it usually. So, I mean, you get to it in Babakama B'Rechav. It says, there was a mice, David was fighting the Plishtim, Vayis'ave David Vayoyma. David had a craving to drink. And he said, Miyashkeni Mayim Mibor Veslechem HaShabashar. I wish somebody could get me some water from that bear. So Vayivku Shlosh Giborim Mach the Plishtim, three Giborim broke through, and Vayivyol David, Vlei Ovolish Toiso. He refused to drink David. Vayasachoisim Lashem, and he poured it out as a korban, as a nesef takashvor. Vayoyma, and he said, Cholilli Hashem Masoisi Zois. Chas v'shalom, I should drink this water. This is the blood of the people who went on the fire at the risk of their lives. This is what they brought back. They didn't want to drink it. Because this wasn't water. This was the blood of the people that went to bring it. And blood is, the makom of dam is mizbeach, not Adam. Adam is a nefesh and belongs to Kadosh Baruch Hu, not to Adam. There's a mice about one of the many mices that Reb Nosson once had a point with a gvir. It was meduber about a very nice sum of money. They came to, but he told them, I have a 15-minute window, you have to be there. They came to the building, he was on the 18th floor, the elevator was broken, and the gvir apologized and said, I'm sorry, it's just not going to be. 13 minutes later, there's a knock on the door. Reb Nosson had schlepped up the 18th flights. The man was astounded, and he said, 2 minutes is not a lot of time. It's enough to write a check, and he gave him a skum hog and b'yaisa. So the people followed the maisa, the goddess Reb Nosson. Fine. But when you come and you build a yeshiva with money that came with your last breath of life, that's money, or that's dama nefesh? What koach of tzmicha does money like that have? The koach of the dama nefesh, of the dama tamtzis, of Reb Nosson with everything he was, lay in that money. And that's how he built it. It wasn't the sum of money. It was vayasachoisim Lashem. When you take your last breath, and you bring with that domim, that becomes a nesef Hashem. People speak about how much he built, and how much he did, and how much he accomplished, the buildings, the Talmidim, and so on. There's another knach in learning it up with a person like that. That's a result of this inyan. The Rambam says in Hilchas Schiris, at the end of Schiris, the Rambam Darka at the end of a series of halachas writes Divrei Musar. The Rambam says, V'chein chayav lavoid b'chol koichay. A worker is obligated to work full strength for a balabayas. Shaharei Yaakov v'atzadik oma, ki b'chol koichay avadit yasavicha. Yaakov v'atzadik said, I worked your father with all my might. Leficha, not al schar zois af be'olam hazeh. He got schar even this world. Shenema vayifatz ha'ish me'oid me'oid. I have two problems with Rambam. First of all, how does Rambam know that this is? How did Rambam make the cheshbon? To the best of my knowledge, none of us are kalim. There's no chazal that says that this is t'mur as that. It says about all the others, they were very matzliach. And also, to say that the high point of Yaakov Avinu is that he got schar in this world. I mean, there are mitzvahs that it says, v'oichol per se, v'olam hazeh, as an added benefit. But the Rambam is finishing Hilchos Schiros and saying, when you work as honestly as Yaakov Avinu, then you're zeichet to have, even in this world's schar. No, even this world is always a fringe benefit. I think the Pshat Rambam is like this. He's medayik from the pasuk. It should have said, "Vayifritzu nechasov tzaynav." The pesukim like that. That his wealth expanded. What does it mean, "Vayifritzu ishmaod mod"? The person expanded. The answer is, wealth that's acquired with a minimum effort, it's not you, it's the wealth. So I have a lot of nechasim, a lot of sheep, and they become, so I have a lot of sheep. It has nothing to do with the person. Kinyanim in this world are insignificant because we leave them here. They don't become part of us and they stay here. But when a person works with something, the whole koicha, and he puts his neshama into it, that becomes part of the person's mitzias. It's mitzarev to his kaima. Just like Chamayor Shapiris Ben Yoyer was a tzaddik because Shapiris Ben Yoyer's stamp lay on him, Yaakov Avinu's nechasim was Yaakov Avinu became nizgada. He didn't leave many buildings. He didn't leave many talmidim. He was a gadol that was mach. Shlomo HaMelech in Mishlei speaks about how ruinous an ish atzel is, that he loses his field and everything falls apart. And that's what's bad with being an atzel. Shlomo HaMelech in Eishes Chayil adds another knetch. Sometimes even Otzel is fortunate, and he gets lechem that's not, he didn't work so hard for. But for someone who's an anina tam, for a person who's a connoisseur, and that has the value of b'chol koichi, lechem atzos loiseichal, the eishes chayil is someone that doesn't serve bread that floated into the house. Every nekuda, every neches, is part and parcel of the person. And that's the only thing that has value, and the only thing that satisfies a person, is when he eats the kav shalom of yegiya and amu. That was a midah, that was a shorishtik midah, in learning, in beram chaveray, in kiyam mitzvahs, in binyan Torah, in abatzas Torah. If I can conclude with the scene that most expressed him, would be an akafis, where they would be dancing, tremendous simcha. He would be sitting there most of the time, not being able to dance. And then he would come to his favorite nigun of Ashrei Misha Moli B'Torah. And he would get a chiyus, jump up, and be mitzarev. The simple way of looking at that, at those words as a chazal, is everybody's amul. Fortunate are those who are amul and tired. But it has another meaning. Even when everybody's learning Torah, fortunate are the people that are amul and tired. Fortunate are people that put their sweat and their heart and the nefesh and neshama into it. Asher Ayin, Rav Nosson Tzvi sitting hours after hour after hour with chavrusas, the same gelassenkeit learning again and again and again, that amul in Torah. Asher ayin rasa, Reb Nosson taking a lulav and esrik with the chavivas of only somebody who has to work so hard to take it has. HaKadosh Baruch Hu was mazin 20 years of extraordinary amul, and that amul brought out in him so much. Ashrei Adam, Ashrei Ish, that saw the way in which he greeted someone with the love and the ava of somebody who was willing to climb up 13 floors with a last breath to enable him to sit and learn. Asher Ayin, that saw someone that lechem atzus loyseichal, that everything, the only thing he wanted were the things that you had to work for, and work till the last drop of sweat's been squeezed out of your body. Asher, the person that saw the simch of an amal b'teira by a kofis, being mefazes and mecharke, and singing Asher Mishamole B'Toyer by Zen Nachas Rav Yitzchak. Special kavod to Nifter and to Tzibur, to be able to hear the behespit from the Shiva's brother, Rabbi Gedalia Finkel, Shlita, Rabbi Mechaim Lechaim, Aram Yeshiva Smir, and like his brother Nosson Tzvi, very much endeared and beloved by his Talmidim. Rabbi Gedalia Finkel, Shlita.
I must say that I have a double heritage here. We've just finished the Shloshim. Indeed, it's Abel Yochi for himself personally. But together, it's an Abel of all Klal Yisrael. The Shama tells us, Lama nisnecha mitzvos Aaron, the Shviras Aluchos. Why is Mrs. Aaron written in the Torah right next to the Shviras Halachos? The lament choshe misasan shal tzedikim koshe difnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu k'Shviras Halachos. Had the Halachos has not been broken, Torah would never be forgotten. The Shviras Halachos or the Yeridus Adoris, Shichas HaTorah. And as difficult it is, Shviras Halachos, so too is the loss of a great tzaddik. The luchos represent a kesher between HaKadosh Baruch Hu and Klal Yisrael. The luchos was a b'china of a ksuva between Klal Yisrael and HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And the break of the luchos was a break of the ksuva, like a break of a shidduch.